আপনারা দেখছেন চ্যানেল বেঙ্গল ওয়াচ নজরবন্দি আপনিও।
দারান দাদা, আপনি কি সঠিক হাতে আপনার সঞ্চয় তুলে দিচ্ছেন? আপনার সঞ্চয় কি সময়ের সাথে সত্যি কি বাড়ছে? যদি আপনার মনে কোনো রকম প্রশ্ন জেগে থাকে, তা প্রপার্টি, মিউচুয়াল ফান্ড, আইনি সমস্যা, ট্যাক্সেশন অ্যাডভাইস, মার্কেট অ্যাডভাইস, ইন্স্যুরেন্স অ্যাডভাইস, রিটায়ারমেন্ট প্ল্যানিং, এমনকি ইনভেস্ট কোথায় করবে, কিভাবে করবে, সব সমস্যার সমাধান নিয়ে আসছে আপনাদের কাছে
সুস্কান প্রেজেন্টস ইনভেস্টমেন্ট আইডিয়াস।
নমস্কার, ইনভেস্টমেন্ট আইডিয়াসে আপনাদের স্বাগত। আমরা কিন্তু আজকে স্টুডিও থেকে বেরিয়ে গেছি এবং পৌঁছে গেছি ইনস্টিটিউট অফ চার্টার্ড অ্যাকাউন্টেন্টস অফ ইন্ডিয়াতে, কারণ এখানে ইনভেস্টমেন্ট আইডিয়াস নিয়ে একটি সেমিনার আয়োজন করা হয়েছে, যেখানে অবশ্যই মুখ্য অতিথি হিসেবে আছেন মিস্টার কানেক জেন এবং আছেন আরও কয়েকজন বিশিষ্ট গুণী ব্যক্তিও। তাহলে চলুন দেখা যাক আজকের এই সেমিনারের মাধ্যমে এই ইনভেস্টমেন্ট আইডিয়াস নিয়ে আরও কি নতুন বার্তা বা নতুন তথ্য আমরা আপনাদের কাছে পৌঁছে দিতে পারি।
Annual General Meeting of the Eastern India Regional Council from 5:30 p.m. at this auditorium. So with this, I welcome Mr. Kanak Jain. Please give a big round of applause. Thank you, Asmita. And now over to Kanak.
See, there are various ways of starting a program which is related to wealth creation and all. But I think the best way to start is first take certain questions from your side, which I'll write on the board and throughout the presentation, so that I focus on only on those questions and thereby we move. Is this an okay format? Because otherwise, no, I should know what is the expectations that way.
Okay, regarding investing abroad, we will not try to, because again that's a very very big topic, but maybe we will just see 2 lakh, this is there, and the taxation part maybe we will be covering, how the Indian as an Indian investor is getting, what is the impact on Indian investors with that, as far as taxation is concerned, with mutual fund schemes or whatever investment. But again, that 2 lakh, how they can invest, I think we should not get into more details of that. But any specifically, if you have knows, what is that you want to ask? 2 lakh rupees that all of us know, $2 lakh.
System has been made open for investment to all category of citizens of this country. Now, government servant, he gets pension. We chartered accountants, not many of us are employed in the government sector, but some of us have also started investing in the national pension system so as to give us a pension after a certain age. The question is, for a government servant, he is not supposed to show his corpus that is lying with the government in his balance sheet while he submits his return of income, because obviously the contributory part of the provident fund is not reflecting in his balance sheet. That remains with the government, out of which the pension is given to the government servant. Now for us who are members of the national pension system, many of us have opened an account in a small way because we get old age pension. Now that corpus, are we bound by law to show it in our balance sheet, since the central government employees are not showing it in their corpus as a in the balance sheet, or are we not supposed to show it as a corpus in the balance sheet and not supposed to declare it as an asset? Because here is a situation that asset will not come to us, that will go for investment by way of annuities, and that we will be getting a certain portion as annuity, although some reservations have been raised that it will not come by way of annuities. The question is, is it an asset class or are we not supposed to show it in the balance sheet?
How this debt funds work? We will be talking about equities. Now just talking about debt, how returns in debt funds come? And maybe there also, see, as we think that if we can invest, if we have certain study or anything like that, put directly into that equity. But again, if you think that no, we want to be relaxed, maybe we can put it through a large share fund or maybe a good fund house or a good fund manager who has a good track record. That's it. Anyone, anywhere. And and in today's era, I'll say a big role a chartered accountant has actually to play for his clients or the people whom he know to their financial literacy to a great extent. I was just sharing this data with Jidhi that in India, we have around 30 lakh insurance agents. But again, these are the people who will only talk about insurance, only talk about human life value and this and that. But again, why? How much insurance one needs? Okay, that's again where an education is required. It's not that you let your client just buy ULIPs and crores worth of rupees and putting into endowment plan which is 2 lakhs of rupees. That's not right way actually. Then what is, how much one insurance needs? How much need of an insurance is? It's based on human life value. And human life value is something which is very simple to calculate. Let's say you are earning 1 lakh rupee per month. Okay? 1 lakh rupee per month or annual income is, let's say, 10 lakh rupees. Then what's the total human life value is? Let's not get into that complicated formulas. Based on that, we can do that. That's obviously there. But it's a 14 time rule. Or something which creates 1 lakh rupees is my human life value. So, if something 14 times, let's say, 1 crore 40 lakhs, okay, if that is the value, which that is the coverage which he is having, he will get 1 lakh rupees for that. And now, talking about real estates, okay, Robert Kiyosaki, he explains balance sheet in a different way, I think, which we all are not. This is the balance sheet and a PL. What is an asset? I'm not obviously talking about the same way which we all are learning.
Okay.
So a car is an asset?
Yes.
Car. House? Okay. Now a house or a car which you have purchased and even EMI is attached to that. Still you will call it an asset.
That's an asset
with the liability attached. So everything getting squared off. So no asset, no liability. That's the trick. Asset actually should be what you said as a definition, should be considered. Maybe accounting point of view, we consider car and house as an asset, but actually it is not an asset. Until and unless it is actually creating income for you. But when we buy a car, we feel so happy and we celebrate. When we buy a house, we feel very happy and we celebrate. But with a house, even the house where we stay, even if there is no EMI, I will not consider it as an asset. Robert Kiyosaki is saying like that. It's not me.
I don't agree on that.
The only reason is, let me finish it. The reason is, with a house, you have so many things to pay. You have your insurance, you have municipal tax and so many things. Which doesn't mean that you will not own a house. You will own a house, obviously. But let's not call it as an asset. Asset is something which actually creates income. Asset is something which is income and expense. Anything which actually creates income is an asset. Anything which take away income from your account is actually not an asset. So if you want to put it just for accounting sake, which you will have to do because that's what the law is, but for an investment point of view, for a wealth creation point of view, we'll only consider an asset which actually works for you and creates income for you. If this house is rented or if this house is put into a commercial use and if it's creating income for us, it's an asset. If that car is put into commercial use and it's creating income for us, this is an asset. This is what the concept of an asset is. As far as wealth planning is concerned, for accounting, there is no debate and we are not going to talk about it. You are staying, your generations will stay there. How does it matter? Any day if you sell it or something like that, then it's a question. So price value, even if it is, see, real estate investment, you don't consider your house as an asset, please. This is not an investment, this is there you are staying. You are not there to sell it.
Efficiency. It impacts it. So you have to consider.
If you are getting income out of it, or try to have real estate, let's say 20% of your income put into an asset, buy a flat with an intention that you are going to rent it, or you are going to generate income out of it. So maybe 20% you are putting into equity, 20% into real estate, but the intention should be like that.
So, but the money saved out of the rent, that means if we don't have our own house, we are going to stay in a rented house.
Ah, that's good. It's very good to have a house. I'm not telling. I also intend to that.
I'm not telling that.
But wealth creation point of view, you should have a different house which is actually creating. Consider that as a wealth asset, not this. This is an asset. Let it be. Consider it. But wealth planning point of view, wealth growth point of view, it should be like that.
It's saving an expense.
Yeah, it's saving an expense, but it is not creating. My point is only consider what is creating. Saving is good, achhi baat hai. But again, create, the whole idea is wealth creation, no. That's, again, I'll give you a calculator, which is there, I can email it to Rajiv ji or whatever, where you can just do the financial planning. This is, this concept of financial planning has actually come into picture. And we do planning for everything. If you want to go a trip to Puri, or anywhere, we will do planning. We will plan for it, we will go, we'll book tickets, book hall, but everything, even this hall, this building, this was made because of a planning. Without planning, this was not possible. Each and every stone and each and every pillar, somebody, an engineer actually printed and actually made everything, and then only things was created. But unfortunately, we plan for everything and accept life. And that's the reason why we all have this struggle of financial freedom or things like that. So that's the reason we will have to just consider anything which is only creating income. Maybe this is a very, especially with chartered accountants, it's not acceptable at all, I know that. And but again, when it comes to wealth creation, we'll have to consider only that asset which is creating income. Otherwise, just it's only that we are feeling happy about it. हमने घर ले लिया, गाड़ी ले ली, just feeling happy about it. So, okay, you can feel happy.
Yeah, that feeling happy is a source of income.
Okay. Let's all feel happy. We feel very happy when you meditate, or we go to Baba Ramdev, let's say, okay, fine. Feeling happy is one good thing, and making it actual reality is a different thing. After that feeling happy, try to create one more house, which actually creates income for you.
Feeling happy feels
after you get motivated, you buy another house. So that's what is required. That is asset. Wo achhi baat hai. Feeling happy, karte rahiye, but at the end, ek aur house nahi. Or put your money. And then sharing. How sharing helps? Because aap kitni sharing karoge, sharing is, I call it tithing. Okay? Not clearance of mind. We all know how to inhale and exhale. Huh? Can we do a little exercise? Let's all inhale. The belly is going in or out?
Out.
Inhale, belly out. Your case? Your case? When you inhale, belly went inside or outside? Inside. Outside. Inside. Oh my God. Everybody is having a different answer. Huh? When we Nisha Smitchi, we are Rukche or Berotche? Berotche, Rukche. See, here also there is a confusion. So actually this is a confusion. But actually if I take an example of balloon, okay? When you blow air inside that, it should blow.
Yes, sir.
And when you air comes out, it should shrink. Same thing is with belly breathing. When you inhale, it should go up, out. So if we are not doing it correctly, we should do it correctly. But again, let's do this thing. When you are inhaling, let the belly come out. So inhale, 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 got stuck, relax. Now do only exhale, 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 got stuck. Why is this happening? Why are we getting stuck? Why we cannot exhale, exhale, or why we cannot inhale, inhale? This is, yes, constraint of the, because this is of the fifth law of wealth creation, and that is, it is in, until and unless we give, we cannot get. Until and unless you exhale, you cannot inhale, because that's the size. Same thing, you know, all of us want, my bank balance should keep growing,
My bank balance should keep growing. I should have only ideas. I should have that knowledge, and that's it. It should be with me. But until and unless we share it, we give it, it's not possible that we get it. I think that this is one of them. So anyways, getting back into real estate and why bullions? Bullions should also form an asset class. It's very, very simple. Whether it is Chanakya or whether it is very, very old economists, they all have been talking about this. Until date, it has actually worked. Whatever we consider, see, before 1971, there was a rule of gold, gold versus currency, if you all are aware of that. There were standards, gold standards, but that was all made, what we call, scrap. And after that, what happened? Any economy or any country can just print as many notes as they wish. I have certain videos where Zimbabwe became bankrupt. It's all because of that. We have minted, we have just printed notes after note. What is this QE1, QE2, QE3, are you aware? They're just printing, that's it. And more they are printing, more things is becoming. See, there is actually no price rise. Inflation jaisi cheez hai hi nahi. There is nothing like inflation. I'll tell you how. See, let's say almonds, remember almonds? You are quite senior, so maybe 30-35 years back, agar aapko 1 kg almonds lena tha, so what you would have done? How much you would have paid? You don't remember, maybe 1 rupee or 2 rupee, things like that, 1 rupee let's say. Huh? But that 1 rupee was a silver coin. So 1 rupee he went and he gave and he got an almond. Today if you will go to that same shop and they will ask you for maybe 800-700 rupees for 1 kg. Which means, instead of that 800 rupees, 700 rupees, if you give that silver coin to him, is that going to be equal? More or less. Because the price of a silver coin is also 700. What does that mean? That point of time, the currency was a coin, which is in bullion. Today, if that same currency was there, there would have been no inflation. Unfortunately, we are paying 700 rupees, which means government of India or any government. Same goes with US government. They have printed 700 notes. This is the concept. And people call inflation, and there are studies and there are economists, and on television we will see so many facts and figures about inflation. I don't understand that. And I don't want to understand that. This is the basic, simple, I think, as an investor, if I can understand things simply, and what I believe is, God has made everything very, very simple. And every, even investments also, if done in a simple way, I think that makes more sense. Anything which is made complicated will never work. That's what, that only works for people who have studied too much. There are so many fancy degrees these days available. And after getting a degree, what do? You will have to do something, no? Now, there are papers people have made with credit card companies. Let's say, a company is having credit card. He's having a debt of 2.5 lakhs, 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, as if they will make a paper out of this. And because they are going to take 13% to a country like Japan, they will sell it at 9%. They will pay 9%. But these people, if they pay, then they are going to pay. And they made a paper. And finally, this is the next crash which is going to happen. After the subprime in 2014-15, you will see this is what is going to be the next big thing. Next big thing which we will be looking at. These papers. And these are fancy papers. So many fancy names they have given. But again, it's good to be simple, and let's only understand and share with our clients. So sharing is very important. I think sharing is something which is patriotic. All of us sitting in this room, if we can share all this, I think this is something which we are doing in a form of tithing.
Sir, how do you explain that if US is printing notes, but despite that, rupee is devaluing against the US currency? So how do you explain this?
A very good question, and I love to answer that. Earlier, there are a lot of serials in TV which I see, you know, Shivaji and Rana Pratap and all these people fighting with so many foreign invasions. Earlier, when one country wanted to rule on another country, you know, they used to evade. They used to use their muscle power. Today it is so simple. It's so simple. In one day you can make 50 rupees, 60 rupees and you have taken so much wealth of that country. That's what they are doing. Not a single channel will show all these things. They will not explain. Nobody will explain this printing of notes. But this is a fact. This is what is happening. We are just again ruled, but in a different way. This is a corporatized way. Earlier British used to rule us, or before that the Mughals, and before that somebody else. But again, the system has remained same. It is on papers. In single day, just you see what has happened. Who else can do that? And you cannot do anything. You can't do anything. We are helpless. Not a single. Why to waste ammunitions? You just got the war won. This is the way they are doing. Again. Can anybody explain? QE1, QE2, QE3? This is the process of simple way of, yes, processing printing notes. There are a lot of definitions. You search for Google, you will get 200 pages on that. But this is a simple way wherein just you can add more debt. US is over $15 trillion dollars debt now. And it just takes any debt means actually you are printing money. All these debt papers, this is not according to that gold standard or any standard. You just printed money, which means, see, you have, I'll explain it in a simple way. A glass of water, or not, a glass of milk. Now, if a doodwala, whose 10 customers are there, now all of a sudden 20 customers are there. And he's having that same one or two cow, and he will have to supply to 20 people. What he will do? He will add 1 liter more. 1 liter to 1 liter. Now he can serve everyone. Everybody is getting milk and everybody is saying, ah, I'm very happy. But actually they are getting half milk, half mutton. After certain time, 10 more people add. Same doodwala, same cows. So he will add, instead of 1 liter, he will add 2 liters. That's what is happening. And the result is, the nutritional value of that milk is actually going down. Isn't it, no? So this is the way Q1 and Q2, Q3, so it's better, no? See, this is the way I think, if I have done planning for so many people, this is the way my set of the people whom I interact with, they understand. And this is the people I also understand. So that's the reason I share it in this way. If I share anything which is complicated, so for them, there are so many people with so many degrees. So they are there to share on CNBC. CNBC is the best channel. I have not watched CNBC for last 5-6 years. I don't remember. That's when I saw. Because anything, whatever you are going to get is a news. And news is something where you make a view and then you put your money and then it's gone. Do your own analysis, learn technicals maybe, look at the balance sheets, we all are there to understand balance sheets and all.
You do have impact on the system.
But whatever I have seen this on this channel, so we have one more channel people shooting this. So.
সেমিনারে উপস্থিত প্রত্যেকেই ইনভেস্টমেন্ট নিয়ে বিভিন্ন প্রশ্নের উত্তর মিস্টার কানাক জেনে থেকে পেলেন। এরকম আপনারাও যদি ইনভেস্টমেন্ট নিয়ে বিভিন্ন প্রশ্নের উত্তর বা ইনফরমেশন বা আইডিয়া জানতে চান তাহলে অবশ্যই আমাদের সঙ্গে থাকতে হবে এবং দেখতে হবে প্রত্যেক শুক্রবার রাত 10:30 ইনভেস্টমেন্ট আইডিয়াস। তাই সঙ্গে থাকুন, দেখতে থাকুন বেঙ্গল ওয়াচ।
আপনারা দেখছেন চ্যানেল বেঙ্গল ওয়াচ, নজরবন্দি আপনিও।